certainly neovascular AMD is still a leading cause of vision loss globally in people with the age of 50 years and above. Anti-VEGF monotherapy does work very well for many patients with wet AMD. However, there's an unmet medical need for sustained efficacy through extended durability in order to reduce overall visit and treatment burden. Unfortunately, real-world data suggests that many patients are still not really achieving or maintaining vision outcomes comparable with those seen in randomized clinical trials. And that is due to the large number of anti-VEGF injections required. Current options still go along with a huge treatment burden for patients and caregivers, and this leads to problems in the real world. Effective treatment to improve vision outcomes and reduce overall treatment burden may require novel treatment options beyond anti-VEGF monotherapy. Yeah, faricimab is the first bispecific antibody, which is actually specifically designed for intraocular use. It independently binds and neutralizes both angiopoietin 2, and that is completely new, and VEGF-A with high specificity and potency. The bispecific antibody has two FAB arms and a specifically engineered FC region. The FC region is needed for the assembly of the bispecific targeting, and it was optimized to reduce the systemic exposure and the inflammatory potential. Preclinical evidence has suggested that combined angiopoietin 2 and VEGF-A inhibition has a potential synergistic effect on vascular stability. And this could translate into sustained efficacy and durability, and thus lead to improved vision and anatomic outcomes beyond anti-VEGF monotherapy. Yeah, the Stairway study was designed to assess extended dosing of faricimab. It evaluated faricimab dosed at 12 and 16 week intervals in patients with wet AMD. The key inclusion criteria were patients with an age of 50 years and above and treatment-naive neovascular AMD. Faricimab patients received loading doses every 4 weeks through week 12, then Q12 week or even Q16 week faricimab through week 48. Patients in the control group, however, received monthly ranibizumab. Best-corrected visual acuity gains over time for both faricimab arms were fully maintained at week 52, despite the dosing at 12 or 16-week intervals. The results were comparable to monthly ranibizumab treatment, which is one of the gold standards for wet AMD treatment. Although faricimab was given less frequently, the proportion of patients gaining 15 letters or more was comparable with one monthly ranibizumab treatment. 65% of patients treated with faricimab were disease activity free at week 24. Yeah, the vessel-stabilizing effects of angiopoietin 2 inhibition could translate into sustained efficacy and durability and thus lead to improved vision and anatomic outcomes beyond anti-VEGF monotherapy. Two identical global phase 3 programs, the Tenaya and the Lucerne studies, where we are also participating in Heidelberg, are currently underway. These studies further assess the safety, efficacy, and extended durability profile of faricimab. Treatment-naive wet AMD patients with subfoveal CNV are randomized to one of two treatment arms. Patients receive faricimab in a Q16-week flexible dosing arm after 4 monthly loading doses, or aflibercept every 8 weeks after 3 monthly loading doses.